The following program may contain coarse language, violence, nudity, mature subject matter, or scenes which may not be suitable for all viewers. Viewer discretion is advised.
This is the Exxon Broadcast Network, broadcasting worldwide on broadcast affiliates and satellite program providers, including CNN Broadcast Network, Sirius Satellite Network, Star Media, Good News Radio Network, Angel Broadcast Network, Wiki Broadcast Network, and WPBN-TV. For more information on the X-Zone Broadcast Network, visit us at www.xzbn.net.
The X-Zone Radio and TV show is largely an opinion talk show. All opinions, comments, or statements of fact expressed by Rob McConnell's guests are strictly their own and are not to be construed as those of the X-Zone Radio and TV show or in any manner endorsed by Rob McConnell, Relmar McConnell Media Company, Talkstar Radio Network, its affiliated stations, or employees.
All Hit Radio.
Welcome to the X Zone, a place where fact is fiction and fiction is reality. Now, here's your host, Rob McConnell.
This ain't no disco. It ain't no country club either. LA.
All I want to do is have a little fun before I die. Just the man next to me, out of nowhere. Apropos of nothing, he says his name is William. I'm sure he's Bill, or Billy, or Mac, or Buddy. And he's played ugly to me. And I wonder if he's ever had a day of fun in his whole life. We are drinking beer at noon on Tuesday. The bar.
And welcome back to the X-Zone, everyone. My name is Rob McConnell, coming to you from our studios in Hamilton, Ontario, Canada. Worldwide, toll-free, 1-800-610-7035. Email X-Zone at xzoneradiotv.com. On MSN Messenger, xzoneradiotv at hotmail.com. And our website, www.xzoneradiotv.com. My guest this hour, X-Zonation, is Bill Sweet. And Bill was always interested in the paranormal, including the spiritual phenomena of prayer. Through meeting the founders of Spindrift, Inc., that's Bruce and John Klingbeil, I believe it's pronounced, Bill began to grasp new ways of applying conscious research to religion and science. Bill learned that the Klingbeils were Christian science practitioners who were doing scientific tests of consciousness and prayer. Bill Sweet was president of Sandrift for 4 years. And joining me now is Bill Sweet. And Bill, welcome to the X-Zone.
Well, hello, X-Zone. Glad to be there. And talking about synchronicity, there's a thing in the news today out of the University of Pittsburgh called the Factor X. Did you hear about that?
No, I didn't.
Well, it's pretty shocking. You remember the movie Cocoon?
Yes.
Where the people jump in the pool and they had lived longer?
Yep.
Well, according to the University of Pittsburgh, I heard on the news today, I can't quite believe it, but some doctors and scientists have come up now with a thing called Factor X, and they're making small animals in the laboratory live 2 and 3 times longer than their lifespans.
Unreal.
And it's unreal. So I thought you'd like that since you're the X-Zone, and this is called Factor X. I just said, well, I had to tell you.
Now, that's synchronicity at its best.
Bill,
what does spindrift mean?
Well, it's a nautical term. I didn't even know what it was until I got involved with Bruce and John Klingbeil. And what happened is that It's the cutting edge of a wave during a hurricane or cyclone out at sea. The spray at the edge of the wave gets blown by the wind, and it causes this fast-moving spray, which is called spindrift. And the analogy to our organization is that we're sort of at the cutting edge of consciousness research and mainline research. And the wave, of course, is visibly water. And then some of the spray is being blown so fast it turns to vapor, which goes into the invisible realm, which is the psychic and spiritual realm. So it's the cutting edge of the wave. That's the spindrift, and that's where the research is taking place, and that's how the organization took its name.
Now, why did Bruce and John think it's so important to blend parapsychology with prayer apsychology?
Yeah, we kind of took the term parapsychology and called it prayer psychology, but it was important because the world is becoming more scientific, and a lot of religious and spiritual values are becoming challenged. And so why not find a way to show that there is a way to combine both? And also, working as Christian Science practitioners, where they were interested in the combination of religion and science anyway, and they happened to be amateur scientists, and they took on a group of us, and we're about 12 amateur scientists working on this. We found that people were, if they didn't get an answer to their prayers or what they were working on, that was pretty obvious. Mm-hmm. But sometimes when people got an answer and had a healing or had something that was the result of good intention or prayer, they would be excited about it for a while, but then some of them would start doubting, or somebody come along and undo it for them, or talk them out of it or whatever. So they said, well, isn't that strange? You know, you would think if somebody had a fantastic experience, they would hold on to it. But it tends to be today, maybe you run into this with some people, that they have an extraordinary experience, and the culture and time and all kinds of things play on them. And
all right, Bill, you and I have to take
this excitement.
We've got to take a commercial break. Please stand by. Bill Sweet is our special guest to this hour, ExoNation. Spindriftresearch.org is the website, and we'll be back on the other side of this break. Don't go away. Modern Esoteric, Beyond Our Senses by Brad Olson, consummates the lifeology story about where humanity originates. It is the lost continents, the primitive wisdom, the mythos of creation, and the rethinking of ancient history as we are taught in academia. There is much more to the story than what we have been told. As this is the first book in the Esoteric series, Modern Esoteric starts at the beginning of time and accelerates up to this modern age. Future Esoteric is book two in the series and takes a forward-looking position ahead of today with an open and honest examination of the ET issue and various unexplained phenomena. To discover the writings of author Brad Olson, visit www.bradolson.com. That's www.bradolson.com. Named one of the world's greatest psychics, Elizabeth Joyce is now giving readings worldwide via Skype. Elizabeth Joyce is recognized for her clairvoyant ability to help find missing persons, her analysis of dreams, past life regression work, mediumship, and her accurate predictions. Elizabeth has been a frequent guest on the X-Zone radio show with yours truly, Rob McConnell, now for several years. For an appointment with Elizabeth Joyce, call 201-934-8986 or Skype at elizabeth.joyce. And for more information, you can always visit Elizabeth Joyce online at www.new-visions.com.
Have a disease that you would like to alleviate through a natural means? Have you been contacted by angels, ghosts, or even extraterrestrials and want to validate these experiences? Or would you simply like to speak with someone who can help you find your life's purpose? I'm Dr. Joseph Mara, and I'm offering my services free of charge for first-time clients contacting me during the month of April. These free consultations include angel card readings, guided meditations, life coaching, and energy healing. If you have always wanted to explore these types of experiences but were skeptical or simply could not afford them, then take advantage of this free special offer. Contact me through my website, aguidinglight, spelled LITE.com, to schedule your consultation today. Until then, I offer you love, light, and laughter.
Exo Nation, Bill Sweet's our special guest, and we're talking to Bill about Spindrift. His website is www.spindriftresearch.org. And Bill, how powerful is the power of prayer, and what is behind the power of prayer?
Well, what we find at Spindrift is that most of the world prays. And it hasn't been looked into too seriously scientifically. Mm-hmm. It's being looked at a little bit in medical circles because they're finding that patients and people want this to happen. And the general feeling is that most people think that thought is thought. You know, it's all the same, and it's just how you intend it. What we feel is distinctive about the Spindrift research is that we feel that there's regular thought, and then there's psychic thought that does things through intention. And then what happens with the holiness factor in prayer is what we term, and well, it's not original, but we've kind of given a new push, is the term quality. The more quality there is infused in thought, the more power there is to the prayer, and it stands, makes it stand out. And the way that works is that quality always moves a system or an organism or whatever the patient is that's being prayed over toward more order. So it's this ordering element that we feel that is isolated in our experiments that you're able to pick out and see as what is behind the power of prayer.
Is there a connection between the power of prayer and psychokinesis and ESP?
You got it. Certainly. They're connected, and that's where you start getting into the emotional controversies with people, because you have the religious and some spiritual people, but let's say just the religious community has a hard time with thinking of anything in psychic terms, yet they're dealing with psychic things all the time. They're just in denial. And so it does. Prayer does move things psychokinetically, and sometimes there's communication through prayer where you get an ESP intuition, what to pray for. I think we all have had experiences like that where I better pray about this instead of that. That's something coming to you is through ESP. And we certainly think that these things are tied. What we feel is if you're going to put things on a sliding scale of a psychic thought, that prayer is on the highest level because it deals with the most quality. The more quality the person can develop in their thought, the better. And quality we can also see in other parts of life, athletic ability, artistic ability, becoming a better radio announcer, whatever. Quality is what improves our consciousness and ends up improving, projected out and improving our circumstances. And that's what prayer does too on a more of a spiritual level.
Now, in your research, have you found the difference in prayers between, let's say, Baptist, Catholic, Zen meditators, Jewish folks, Hindus, and so on?
That's really a funny thing, because when our research began, and I was at the beginning of the research, was in 1969 here in the suburbs of Chicago. Mm-hmm. Well, we just had the idea that, you know, maybe when we start looking into this, we're going to find out there's a whole lot of difference between how a Jewish person prays and a Muslim prays and a
right.
Baha'i prays.